Hi! In this video, I'm going to show you how to add a cover page with a contact capture form and walk you through all the settings from A to Z. In Tilda library, you'll find a variety of cover blocks with different features. To create a cover and add a contact form for collecting visitors' information to it, you can choose the relevant cover blocks from the library. In some covers, you can add a single input field. If it's not enough and you want the visitors to be able to share more contact info, you can use the cover with a form containing several input fields. I will show you how to configure such cover using the block CR32N. I will explain how to add a background image, adjust the text display, and add input fields. Let's say I'm creating a page for a painting workshop. Here section is the first thing that the visitor sees when they enter the website. The cover with the contact form allows you to present the offer concisely and give the visitors an opportunity to sign up for the event right away. Let me add the CR32N block to the page. Now let's open the content panel of the cover block. The content panel includes several tabs available for editing. In the title and description tab, you can edit the text on the cover. The cover tab allows you to upload a background image or video. And under input fields, you can set up the online form fields. Below, you can connect data capture services so that the form submissions will be automatically sent to the connected services. For example, to your email, Google Sheets, a CRM system, or any other services you connect in the site settings. Also below, you can change the title and description of the form and specify the success page URL where the user will be redirected after submitting the data successfully. Now let me show you the parameters in detail. The text in the cover is crucial as it's the first message that the website visitor sees. By default in the title and description tab, you'll find a preset text. To tell the visitors about the workshop and encourage them to sign up for it, I'll type oil painting workshop in the title field. Under description, I'll type the goal of the workshop. Learn composition, form and color and create your own art in just 4 hours. Now let me save it. And have a look at how the text is displayed. Now let's open the cover tab and upload the background image. You can drag and drop the image, add its URL, or select the file from your desktop. I'm going to upload the image from the desktop. The best size for the background image is 1680 pixels in width. When choosing the right image, select the photo that makes it easy to read the text on top of it. You can also add a background video instead of uploading a regular photo. To use video as a background, you can either enter the YouTube URL or specify the link to the MP4 or WebM file hosted on a third-party server. For my example, I'm going to go with the background image, not a video. Right, let's move on. It's time to set up the online form. By default, several fields are added in the Input Fields tab. I'm going to delete them and configure the form from scratch. First, let me add the field to enter the name. Click Add Input Field and select the name field type. Note that there are more than 20 types of fields on Tilda. Each field type has several parameters that you can flexibly configure. The input placeholder is the text that is displayed in the field by default until it's clicked. It's a tip for the visitors with an example of how this particular field should be filled in. So I can type any name here, James Miller for example. The input title is the text displayed above the field. I type in name here. The input subtitle is the text that is located right below the form title. I'll leave this field empty. The variable name is the system identifier of the field that is not visible for the users. If a specific variable name is required by the data capture service, you can enter it here. For example, MailChimp uses the preset variable names called merge tags. You can also make the field required by clicking the relevant box. I select the name input field is mandatory so that the visitors won't be able to submit the form without filling out this field. The next input field is the email address. To add it, I select the email field type. Here I'm going to add the input placeholder and the input title. I type example at business.com in the input placeholder field. The title of this field should be email. I'll make this field the required one too. Next field in my form is the phone number, so I add another field and select the phone number field type. Under input placeholder, I enter an example phone number, +1 212 777 1616. Under the input title, I type phone number. You can also configure the mask for the phone field type. The mask allows you to set the data format for the input field. You can specify that if you're expecting to receive only numbers or only letters, for instance, and set the number of characters. The purpose of using the mask is to help visitors avoid making errors in the form. You can select between two mask types, the custom mask and the auto mask with the country code. The custom mask allows you to set the required data format using the mask feature manually. If I select the auto mask with country code option for the field, the country code for the user's phone number will be detected automatically using the location of the website visitor. Let me set this field as required too by selecting the relevant checkbox. Below you can set a separate title and description just for the form. You can try and encourage visitors to leave their contact details with this copy. For example, under title in form box I can type "Sign up for a free class with our lead teacher." I'll also delete preset text in the description in form box field. The button copy can be edited here too. Let me use "Sign up for the workshop." Don't forget to personalize the success message here. By doing that, the visitors will see a personalized copy after clicking the Sign Up button. I'm going to write, "Thank you. You have successfully registered for the event and we look forward to your attendance. Check your email for confirmation." Under Success Page URL, you can enter the link to the page where the user will be redirected after successfully submitting the form. Success pages often come with a special offer or a gift for signing up. I'm going to leave this field empty. In the text under button inform field, you can write a copy informing visitors that by signing up, the user agrees to the terms of the privacy policy and add a link to the online document. Let me add the disclaimer. I have read and agree to the privacy policy. Here I can also insert a link to any word in the field, so I am going to add a URL to the phrase privacy policy. Alright, let me save the changes and take a look at the result. In the cover block, you can now see the copy encouraging visitors to sign up for the event, as well as the background image and the form with all the relevant input fields. By default, form submissions are sent to the lead section of the project. To receive the leads to your email or any other data collection service connected to the project, simply select the required service under Form Data Receiver in the content panel of the block. If no data capture service is connected to the project yet, go to the Forms tab and connect services under Data Collection Services. Let me select the Data Collection Service to receive the submissions to the email and save the changes. Now every time a visitor successfully submits the application, the lead info will be sent to this email and will be also saved in the lead section of the project. In this section, you can also see error logs and quickly fix any issues with received submissions, as well as make sure that the form works correctly. Also, you can decide if you want to keep form submissions here for 30 days, 1 day, or avoid saving them at all. The last option is useful if you don't want your visitors' data to be stored on Tilda's servers. Now let's take a look at the settings panel of the block. Here you can adjust the cover block width as well as the form width and configure the height of the block. I want to make the form a bit wider, so I set the second block width value to 5 columns and select No Offset under the second block offset. Then I save the changes and check what the cover width the form looks like now. If you have several forms on the website and you want to know where exactly the entries are coming from, you can add a unique title for the specific form in the form name field. This value is not visible to the website visitors. I name this form Cover Form. Using the horizontal flip option, you can mirror the form and the copy position to each other. Let me check the box and show you what it looks like. You can see that the form and the main copy have swapped places. Let me uncheck the box to use the default positioning. In the same section, you can also adjust the look of all the elements in the block separately, for the cover, copy, and the form. In the Cover Style tab, I select the fixed value for the background scroll effect option. Then I want to specify the border radius in the Form Style tab. and add the border in the Form Input Style tab. Let me save the changes and show you what the cover block looks like now. Can you see that when I scroll the page, the background image remains fixed? That's the background scroll effect in action. In the Buttons tab, you can adjust the button style. Let me quickly change the background color of the button using the palette. In the Typography tab, you can change the cover text styles by adjusting the font size, color and type, as well as the weight, margins, line and letter spacing. I'm going to set the title top margin to 60 pixels and adjust the title font weight. I save the changes and hear what the cover looks like now. I would prefer to get back to the default value for the title font weight. In the Background Video tab, you can adjust how the background video is displayed. For example, check the box if you don't want to loop the video. Since I use an image, not a video, for the cover's background, I'll leave the default settings here. Please note that the background video in the cover won't be played on mobile devices, since most mobile browsers restrict video autoplay, so you'll have to add the background image for mobile devices. In the Animation tab, you can select how the text and form appear on the page and adjust animation for the button. Let me select the flash effect for the button value and save the changes. You can already see how the flash effect works on the button. The next option allows you to add a navigation arrow to the bottom part of the block. The arrow shows that the page can be scrolled down. Let me add the arrow, save the settings, and now you can see it at the bottom of the cover block. This arrow is clickable and automatically brings visitors to the next block on the page. You can use the background image position to adjust the background image display. I won't change the default value for this cover and show you how this option works with a different image. Let's say I've uploaded another background photo in the Content tab. Originally, this photo looks like that. If I choose the bottom center value in the background image position, the person in the photo gets cropped out. To fix it, I select the top center value, and the person in the photo is now displayed correctly for all screen resolutions. To improve the search engine ranking and help the website rank higher in the search engine results page, you can set the main title tag of the page. To do that, in the settings panel of the block, select the H1 value for the SEO title tag option. This option isn't displayed on the page and is only visible to the search engine robots. Please pay attention to the tip at the bottom of the Settings tab. It reads, "Submitting the form will appear as a page view in the analytics system." To track submitting forms in the web analytics system, such as Google Analytics, you can create a conversion goal using virtual pages. To create such a goal, set visiting the virtual page as a conversion action. The page URL is specified right here in the block settings. This virtual page will be automatically sent to the analytics system every time the form has been submitted. Note that the visitor who has submitted the form doesn't actually go to the virtual page in the browser. All the data transfer between your website and the analytics system happens behind the scenes. Making submission of an online form a conversion goal will make it easier to track conversions in the analytics systems. Let's save the changes and publish the page. Here is how the block is displayed on the published page. You can interact with it and send it as submission. Now the website has the cover with an opportunity of submitting the contact form. The copy on the left encourages visitors to sign up for the workshop. Right next to it, an online form that allows visitors to quickly submit their data. You can find a detailed guide on working with covers and forms in Tilda Help Center. Here you can learn how to configure the background image for the cover page, how to change text formatting, and also how to work with forms and correct data submission errors. Thanks for watching and good luck with creating wonderful websites. Bye!